What's up guys, Greg here with Lens4to-Go and welcome back to the channel. A lot of you have been asking to see more lighting breakdowns and I'm finally able to bring you a few of them from a recent music video shoot that I did with Gradient Films. If you want to check out the vlog and the behind the scenes, I'll throw a link to it right up here. The shot we're going to be looking at today is the one right behind me on the screen. I'll play it for you so you can see how the actual shot came out and then I'll get into the lighting breakdown. So let's roll it. So let's start off with the camera settings. We shot on the Arri Alexa Mini. We shot in 4K. Our white balance was 4300 Kelvin so that we get that cool moonlight coming in. And then we have the warm quasars on the wall. Our ISO was 800. We shot wide open at a T2.8 on the Ingenue Optimo style cine zoom lens, 30-76. And we played around with the focal length as well during it. So I don't have an exact one for this specific shot. And there were no NDs or any sort of filters on it. If you want to see all of our camera settings, they'll be in the description down below. So here's a little behind the scenes shot, and I'll be jumping back to this periodically to show you where we're setting up lights and what lights we're turning on. So here's what the shot looked like when we turned all of the lights off. We are shooting at night, so it's pretty dark outside, but there are a few lights from buildings that are across the way through the windows that you can see. We have the outline of our subject right about here, right in the center of the frame, but pretty much everything else is dark, so we're working with a pretty clean slate. The first light that we're gonna add is our overhead light, and this is gonna be our main key for our talent. Let's jump back to that behind the scenes shot so you can see what we have going on. Starting at the top, we have a 4-foot Kino case, but we have four 4-foot quasars in it instead of the Kino flow tubes, and they are balanced to 5600 Kelvin. Hanging below that, we have an 8x8 frame way up overhead, giving us that really nice soft top light coming down and wrapping around our subject on its face. And then hanging off that frame in the back, we have this skirt, which is just blocking off light from hitting these white posts so they don't overexpose. And then it's also knocking down the ambient light in the background here. The next light that we added was our background rim light and the light coming through the window. This was a Hive Wasp that we had placed just outside. I'll show you a little behind the scenes. Here's the Hive Wasp just booting up. And this big thing on the left side of the frame is the windows that we're shooting through. So that's where you're seeing those rays of light coming in. And we also had some fog, which is really giving it that atmosphere. We're also getting some nice shadows of the window frames on the wall over here. The next lights that we start to add are the quasars. First, the 4 foots that we have on these posts. We just wanted to have something that gave a little bit more interest. So we have one here and one here. And both of these lights are balanced to 3200 Kelvin. And that's giving us that warm look because our camera is set at 4300 Kelvin. Because of how shiny these floors are, there's also some really cool reflections on the ground. And you'll see that more with the 2 foots that we put up in the background. Talking about those 2 foots, those are the last two lights that we added in. So we add them right back here and here. And again, those are balanced to 3200 Kelvin as well. And we're getting some awesome reflections in the ground on the wood and a little bit hitting these metal things, which I wish wasn't there. I wish it was solid wood all the way through, but what can you do? It's a pretty simple setup. Let me run through all of the lights so you can see them as we turn them on and off. Starting with the no lights, we added in the overhead. Then we added in the Hive Wasp out on the roof coming through the window. Then we added in the 4 foot quasars on the pillars. And lastly, the 2 foot quasars in the background, also giving a little bit of an optical illusion that the background's much further away because they're smaller and giving those really cool reflections on the ground. And that's gonna wrap it up for this cinematography lighting breakdown. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this little breakdown for the setup of this music video. If you wanna learn more about any of the gear that we used, it will all be linked to in the description below. So definitely go and check those links out. We have a couple more videos coming out from this video shoot, so stick around for those. And if you enjoyed this and wanna see more just like it, make sure to hit that like button. Also subscribe for new videos every week, and I'll see you in the next one.